Hey, everybody. I've had a number of people mention to me that they've really appreciated the little video I did at the end of one day last December about a certain reading order for nine different Nine Marks books that would take you through the basic ideas of Nine Marks literature. I did that just kind of as a whim because I had a number of conversations with people in the weeks prior to that, which I'd laid out the same order of books and had feedback they found it helpful. I thought, oh, I should just share this, see if people find it helpful. Well, now, a year later, since Nine Marks published that video, I've gotten all kinds of feedback how helpful that was. A lot of pastors, and including some whole congregations, have been following that reading plan this year and found it really helpful. That's great. So some people have said, hey, could you do another one for next year? Well, I don't think I have an infinite number of these, but when the question came up for, do you have like one more where we could do this? I immediately thought, yeah, I've got a great one that I would love to share, and it's this series of books. We deliberately wrote this series of books to be shorter than my Nine Marks of a Healthy Church, exactly so that it would be more easily readable by the elders and deacons in your church and just by every member of your church. And they follow along the Nine Marks plus a little bit more. And so I think if I just walk you through these really briefly, you might see how this could be a very good reading plan for 2020. It's even a great idea. A reading plan for 2020, clarifying our theological vision. Oh, yeah. So, January, start out with Expositional Preaching by David Helm. Maybe the best book in the whole series. Certainly one of the best books in the whole series. David has done a tremendous job, pastor in Chicago. And everything starts with God's Word, God speaking to us. So that's January. February, Nick Roark and Robert Cline do a great job in giving a summary of the storyline of the Bible. So introduce people, other members of your church, members in the church, to a good summary of biblical theology. But also, when I talk about theology that's biblical, I do also mean doctrine that's orthodox. And so Bobby Jamieson has this volume called Sound Doctrine. So for March, what about reading over Bobby's little book, Sound Doctrine, to try to help people see the importance of the truth and knowing the truth? And then in April, how appropriate, when we've got Together for the Gospel coming up, read Ray Ortlund's on the Gospel. Get clear on what the Gospel is in April as you read this with people. A number of folks have commented on how poetic Ray's prose is, how he helps the Gospel to sing in his recounting of it here. So see if you like this one, if you find this one helpful. And then in May, you get to one of the most important theological issues of our day. There are a lot of good books out there on this these days, which I'm very thankful for. Nine Marks has another one by Mike McKinley called How Can I Be Sure I'm a Christian? Or Am I Really a Christian? Rosaria Butterfield's book, Openness Unhindered, is basically on this. I'm talking about the doctrine of conversion. And Michael Lawrence has written one of the best books I've seen on conversion. Again, it's short. Use this for May and see if this would clarify the minds of your leaders and your church about what it is you want to see happen in people's lives. Even the table of contents is worthwhile. Anyway, June, Mack, Stiles on Evangelism. Now, last year I skipped June, July, August, gave them summer off, but this year we're going to go through summer. And June is a great time to read Evangelism by Mack. This is one of the very well-written ones. Mack does an unusually good job in showing how the whole church is involved in evangelism. Super encouraging read. And then in July and August, doing a little conceptual heavy reading, the same size, but it's the two Jonathan Leeman contributions. This would be in July, church membership, and then in August, church discipline. As you try to think through what exactly is the form of the love that we're supposed to have for one another in the local church. It'll get you ready for fall, when you come in fall and September with Church Elders by Jeremie, Rinne. And then in October, my contribution, Discipling, to try to think of how we help each other follow Jesus. And then November, a great contribution, one of the newest ones in the series by John Onwuchekwa, pastor in Atlanta, on prayer. And again, this is kind of like Mack's book in Evangelism. This isn't just on prayer. It's particularly prayer in the life of the local church. What a great emphasis in November. And then finally, in December, what an appropriate time, missions. Andy Johnson wrote this wonderful little book on missions, which looks at what does the Bible teach us about sharing the good news of Jesus Christ, not just at Christmas time, but all through the year and all around the world and all down the ages, All of that is packed in this little book. It could be a great read for December. So friends, that's the thought. This series of books that we've provided, which is deliberately written and at length that should be easily readable by a lot of people, could be a way for you to help clarify your theological vision of the Christian life and the local church especially in 2020.